I mean, sorry, I had to delete some. You know how I be doing. So I need some cameras over in there, bitch. Cause that's really the only thing that's stopping me with music video right now. And it's fucked up. Really all it is. Just, I don't have space on my phone. Like, I don't know why. I just don't. As a rapper, you expected to go to jail. Not expected it. Like, I don't mean it like you literally are guaranteed to go to prison just for having a rap. I don't mean it like that. But I mean, should the circumstances arise where you need to go to jail, you are gonna be put on the chopping block to go to jail, go to prison, go to the feds even possible. Yeah. And like that, like there's, I feel like there's part of like an unsigned agreement you like sign up for with this shit, where it's like, yo, the shit is going, you know what I'm saying? Some people, I don't know why, they get the delusion you gonna sign to a label and it's automatically M's. Listen, if a label pay me $60,000 up front, I feel blessed. I don't care what the shit look like on the back end, cause we gonna work up from there. You know what I'm saying? I understand. You don't come in the game making six figures. You feel what I'm saying? Like, but as long as I'm making some decent pay, I don't care. And like with me, I don't look at it like a label would give a motherfucker more. I don't know about say guidance like that too, but like it's just like having a facility where motherfuckers is always working there. Cause like it's hard as an artist doing this shit all by yourself. You know what I'm saying? So it would take that whole shit out the equation. But there's only certain labels I'd sign to. And them labels have nobody on their track record who has mysteriously cropped up dead for maybe it wasn't for a financial recovery. Who knows? Who knows? Like, all I know is this dude flops and you have $1 million life insurance on him and you can make a moment happen. Some of these people are sick, and I know that. Why do you think I won't sign with a lot of labels? Like, I don't care what they got. It's not going. Nah, don't even waste your time, man. There's somewhere, it would honestly kind of shock you. Like, I would entertain conversations of signing with Jay Prince in some type of way. It would be something very small and preferably one-off if possible, but yeah, because you know what it is? Because I understand him to an extent. Shit has to happen, man. Shit happens. But anyway, so as a rapper, you expected to go to jail. Not expected it. Like, I don't mean it like shit happens, so shit has to happen. So I think they were hoping to get Tory kicked out of America. That's what I think they were hoping for. But they knew. Because it's not just like you, this is not just something you have to do for your career, I don't think. You do this because certain other celebrities above you in the bigger play of things, I think, enjoy seeing it. I'm not going to hold you. Fucked up, but I think that's what it is in some cases. I don't know for sure. It's just because of how many non-rap figures are so adjacent to rap figures. And they're all, not all, but a lot of them are like Miss West and them. I think I could say it like that. Allegedly. I think I even have to throw that in with it. But you know, the ones from the Lord of the Rings, you feel me? Like that, you know, magicians and shit. Allegedly. Like, I think they get off on seeing people go to prison. I think a lot of lawyers, not just prosecutors, attorneys too, like motherfuckers you will hire to defend you, I think get off on you going to prison. The way the lead attorney acted one time, he was like, bro, there was times I was at my practice, and we're talking about this guy getting X amount, and we're laughing about it. I'm representing this guy, and that was not professional.
The lead attorney.
I would not want that motherfucker as my lawyer. Shout out Stuart Hawkins, man. Shout out John Lewis. Shout out all the real ones, you feel me? Shout out Scott McCarthy. All the real lawyers. Shout out Luke Tallarico. Shout out all the real lawyers, you feel me? You know what I'm saying? Ben Shapiro.
Oh, yeah. Shout out Ken Taylor, too. I don't know how I forgot Ken Taylor. Yeah, no. Shout out the real ones, though. Even crackhead Legally Blonde, man, who I did not hire. Shout out her for taking the case for $25.
Yeah, I got like 5 of them bitches on speed dial.
You feel me? Like, I got multiple kinds of them motherfuckers, too. What?
Anyways, that's a side effect of when beating a case becomes like a feeling of euphoria, like some type of drug that's a stimulant. Makes you feel like you're on dust and you're Superman. For real, like that's the only thing I could ever compare to that, and like the MDMA. Well, I don't think it was just MDMA. I think it was cut with something like bromo that lasted a long time. Cause went to bed and woke up rolling 4 fucking days in a row, and it was purple, which when bromo goes bad, it starts to turn like pink. It's like a whitest paste powder that turns pink when it starts to like age. But yeah, so Meg, when this backfires on you and you go to prison for at least false sworn statement, okay? Because that's a little 6-7 month bid. That's a felony. It's a felony. You can't do no with no gun again, because you're going to get criminal. You're going to have to do a mandatory 5. But depending if it's more than just a gun, if you know what I'm saying, you might have to do some more time than that. But anyways, this is definitely, Meg, if you see this, it's no hard feelings, going to backfire on you, I believe. And I don't think they care about that. You shouldn't think someone care about you who's entertaining the idea of your man flirting with her right there. And you know, you feel what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Your man, look, dudes can be pigs sometimes. That is what it is. But like, if motherfuckers cared about you, do you think they'd entertain that? Or you think they would like try to, you know what I'm saying, make a scene about it, be like, Meg, check this out, this motherfucking scumbag did it. Well, it's publicity either way. So, my point being, I think there's an element of society that is very rich and powerful that enjoys seeing black men, especially if they've been a thorn, and you don't see it really happen to white boys. Like, when you do, it's over some shit like that validated happened in the streets, like with EBE bands. You don't just see it happen in a way where it's like people are like, yeah, the industry was involved in that, they had to be. Like, that just doesn't look right. Like with Mo 3, that was probably the biggest one, right? And like, I know nothing about his catalog other than that. I just know a lot of people fuck with his catalog, so I have to say it was fire. Which is really sad when you see a motherfucker who, like, he was talented, and all I know about him is like the way he died, because it's just, that's something you don't see. But yeah, like, I don't think this is going to hurt Tory in any way. I really don't. I do believe, if I'm right about that, it is going to, it's gonna make, they're gonna make it look at first like it's just gone away. It's just dismissed. In about 2 weeks, Meg is gonna be charged after that, I would believe, with at the least false sworn statement. That's if they're just trying to like get her in jail. What I think they're trying to do is they're trying to have this bitch come out of jail, be looked at harder than Remy Ma. That's what I think they're trying to do. And to do that, They'd have to have her do at least like 5 or something, right? So I think they might even charge her with public discharge of a firearm, or like reckless discharge firearm, and like maybe some other shit like reckless endangerment,
whatever the other, because in California, I know they get a lot of leniency in how to move statutes and make things apply to shit they really shouldn't apply to. Like, that's why people were sitting in prison for life, three strikes, and the third strike was stealing a fucking lawnmower that doesn't even have a $50 resale value. I'm out of this bitch, man. Yeah, just, that's the play. And you...